Hi, welcome to this Excel tip. This video is going to show you how to create menus using Excel. Menus can be really helpful in Excel because maybe all the time you don't want the user to be able to input whatever they would like. You may want to control what another person can input in your Excel spreadsheet. Or you may want to control what you can input. So I'm going to give you a very simple example, but obviously menus can be used in many more complex ways. So let's look at this easy example. The goal of this Excel spreadsheet is to pick a grocery list full of 10 fruit and calculate their cost and deliciousness. And here's the menu of fruit that you have to choose from: apples, oranges, pears, and bananas, and their respective costs and deliciousnesses. I don't know if deliciousness is a word, but we'll go with it. So the first thing, we want to be able to just choose between apples, oranges, pears, and bananas in our list right here. And then we want to, from the one that we choose, we want to input the cost and deliciousness automatically. So this video is just going to show you how to create the menu, and the next video will show you how to select the cost and deliciousness automatically. So what we're going to do is something called data validation, and it's under the data tab of Excel. So we're going to go to data if we're not already there, and then we're going to go to data validation. Now, we can do a bunch of different things with data validation. So we can see this is, with data validation, it's allowing, we can allow any whole number, any decimal, and we can even do a minimum and maximum, a list, a date, a time, a length of text, or a custom. So we're not going to mess around with much of this, but you can mess around with other of these. It's pretty self-explanatory. The list is probably the one that's going to be used for menus. So let's go ahead to list. So what we're going to do is we want to only allow the user to select a certain number from the list. So we're going to that source is going to be our apples, oranges, pears, and bananas. And then we could put an input message in here, and we'll do it. We'll say fruit selection is our title, and our input message is going to say select a fruit. We'll make it lowercase for your grocery list. Great. So now you can see it comes up when I click on the cell. It comes up with the directions and a little drop-down menu. So we can only pick apples, oranges, pears, or bananas here, only from the list that we selected. So let's go ahead and pick oranges. Okay. So what's the same thing about Excel all the time is we can even take the lower right-hand corner and drag it down. And now our menu is all here. So now we can pick different fruits for our grocery list. Okay, so that's how to do menu creation in Excel. Thanks for watching.